एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल लर्न कॉमर्स विद नमिता। आई एम नमिता माने। इन टुडे सेशन लेट अस डिस्कस कंज्यूमर प्रोटेक्शन एक्ट 1986। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस एक्ट, फर्स्ट विल ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड हु इज अ कंज्यूमर। सो अ कंज्यूमर इज एनी पर्सन, कंज्यूमर इज एनी पर्सन हु बाइज एनी गुड्स और सर्विसेज for a consideration. Consideration is in terms of money. So any person who purchase or who buys any goods and services from the seller and in terms of money, that person will be called as consumer. So in short, a consumer is a purchaser of goods or services. Next, a consumer also includes any user. A consumer includes any user of such goods or services other than person who buys goods for consideration. Now, this point means that a consumer includes any user. Okay. For example, suppose a father has purchased a mobile phone for his son. So the father has become a consumer because he has buy or he has purchased mobile phone. Okay. For whom he has purchased the mobile phone? For his son. And that mobile phone, son is going to use it. So user of such goods or service is called as consumer. Okay. A consumer also includes any user. So father has purchased the mobile phone, so he is also a consumer, and plus the son is going to use that product or use that goods, so he is also a consumer. So both the purchaser of the goods and the user of the goods is called as consumer or is a consumer. Next, consumer does not include, okay, does not include a person who obtained such goods or service for resale or for any commercial purpose. If a consumer is using that goods or service for the purpose of resale or for any commercial purpose, then that person is not a consumer. So this is the meaning of a consumer. Next, we'll see the definition of a consumer. So, as per Consumer Protection Act 1986, consumer means any person who buys or avails any service for a consideration which has been paid or promised or partly paid and partly promised under any system of deferred payment, etc. So this is the definition of consumer. Next, we'll see the meaning of consumer protection. Now, everyone by now has understood what is the meaning of consumer. So consumer means a person who purchased the goods and services. Now, in front of consumer, you can see the word protection. Now, what is the meaning of protection? Protection means to cover, okay, to save. Now, the meaning of consumer protection means protecting the consumers. From what the consumers are being protected? From unfair and restrictive trade practices adopted by the seller of goods and services. So, consumer protection means protecting the consumers from unfair and restrictive trade practice, which are adopted by the seller of goods and services. Next is the overview. What is the overview of Consumer Protection Act 1986? So this act was enacted on 24th December 1986. So this act was came into force or where it was applicable to whole India on 24th December 1986. This act is divided into 4 chapters and 31 sections. This act covers the provisions relating to the protection of consumers' interest, establishment of consumer councils and other authorities for settlement of consumer disputes. Consumer disputes means suppose a consumer has any complaint against any seller. So, according to this act, there are some forums or courts which have been established only to see or to protect the consumer's interest as well as consumer complaints. Consumer Protection Act 1986 is applicable to whole of India except state of Jammu and Kashmir. Now consumer, next point is important. Consumer Protection Act 1986, okay, previously this act was there. Now in the year 2019, this act is replaced by Consumer Protection Act 2019. So Consumer Protection Act 1986 is old act and this act is replaced by Consumer Protection Act 2019. In Consumer Protection Act 2019, there are some changes which are made in the 2019 Act. And this Act means Consumer Protection Act 2019 is applicable to whole of India and it also includes state of Jammu and Kashmir. Okay. So in 1986, Consumer Protection Act 1986, it was applicable to whole of India, but Jammu and Kashmir was not included in that act. But in the 2019 Consumer Protection Act 2019, this act is applicable to whole of India and it is also applicable to the state of Jammu and Kashmir. So this is the recent changes which is made in this act. Next, now we'll see the rights of consumer. Now what are the rights of consumers as per Consumer Protection Act 1986? Now these acts are same in Consumer Protection Act 2019 also. So first is right to safety. Now right to safety means every consumer has right to be protected against the marketing of goods and services which are hazardous to life and property. So every customer, okay, or every consumer, before purchasing any product, the consumer should check the quality of the product and the guarantee of the product of goods and services. So the every consumer has right to safety. Second, right to choose. Every consumer has a right to choose from the variety of goods and service at competitive price. Next is right to be informed, oblique information. This means that right to be informed, every consumer has right to get the information of his product or of his goods. So right to be information means if the consumer is purchasing any goods, so he or she has right to get the information about the product like quality, quantity, purity, standard and price of the goods so as to protect the consumer against unfair trade practice. So right to be information means right to be informed. The every consumer has right to be informed about the quality, quantity, purity, standard, price of goods so as to protect the consumer from against unfair trade practice. Next is right to be heard. This right to be heard is every consumer has the right to be heard and to be assured that consumer's interest will receive due consideration. Next right is right to consumer education. Every consumer has right to acquire knowledge and skills to be informed, okay, to the consumer throughout the life. Next is right to seek redress. This means that right to seek redress means against the unfair trade practice or exploitation of consumers. It also includes right to fair settlement of genuine grievances of consumers. Right to seek redressal means, now redressal means compensation. Suppose a consumer has faced any unfair trade practice or exploitation, so he has right to get the compensation of the loss which he or she has suffered. Next we'll see Consumer Protection Council. Now Consumer Protection Councils are set up according to this act. So Consumer Protection Act 1986 gives some guidelines or provisions to set up the Consumer Protection Councils. Now these councils act as an advisory, okay, it act as an advice to the consumer. So these councils are advisory bodies. It has been established at three levels. So these councils are established at three levels. First is Central Consumer Protection Council, Section 4. Second is State Consumer Protection Council, Section 7. And third is District Consumer Protection Council, Section 8A. Okay, so these are three councils which are set up as per the Act. And these councils gives the advice to the consumers. Now if as a consumer you have faced any unfair trade practice, so you can go to these councils and there they will, these councils will help you to give you the advice like how you can file a complaint, etc. Okay, so these are the three councils: Central Protection Council, State Protection Council, District Protection Council. Now the establishment of central, state and district is done by, now Central Protection Council is established by central government, State Protection Council is established by state government, District Consumer Protection Council is established by state government. Okay, so state as well as district protection council is established by state government, and only Central Consumer Protection Council is established by central government. Now chairman of this council, chairman of Central Protection Council is minister in charge of consumer affairs in central government. Chairman of State Protection Council is minister in charge of consumer affairs in state government, okay. And in District Consumer Protection Council, the chairman of this council, of this district council, is collector of district, okay. So in central, the minister in charge of consumer affair in state government, the chairman, and chairman in state Consumer Protection Council will be the minister in charge of consumer affairs in that state, in that state government. And for district, the chairman will be the collector of the district. Now the meetings of these councils are held, numbers of meetings, next point, in for central council, the meeting is at least one meeting every year. For state, at least two meetings every year, and for district, at least two meetings every year. Now scope of this council, means Central Consumer Protection Council, is for entire nation. State Consumer Protection Council is for respective state, and District Consumer Protection Council is for respective district. Next is objective of Consumer Protection Council. Now what are the objectives of this Consumer Protection Council. It is established by the Act, as per the Act. Now, what are the objective? What is the function of this councils? So, the object of central, state and district council shall be to promote and protect the right of the consumers. So, the object of central, state and district councils shall be to promote and protect the right of the consumers, such as, now these rights are same as the rights of the objectives or objects of consumer protection councils are same as the rights of consumers. So first right is the right to be protected against the marketing of goods and services which are hazardous to the life and the property. Next is the right to be informed about the quality, quantity, purity, standard and price of goods so as to protect the consumer against unfair trade practice. Next is right to choose from variety of goods and service at competitive price. Next, right to be heard and be assured that consumer interest will receive due consideration, and right to seek redress against unfair trade practice or exploitation of consumers. Means the consumer has right to get the compensation which the consumer has suffered, and if the consumer has suffered any loss. And last is right to get consumer education. So these are the objects of Consumer Protection Council. So I hope you have understood the Consumer Protection Act 1986. Thank you very much. Please subscribe my YouTube channel, like and share the video, and do not forget to press the bell icon to get the latest notification.